Hi, I'm Raf. I'm a programmer working on the Google Chrome extension system. I'm here to talk about the design of the APIs you'll use in creating your extension. One goal in the design of the extension system is that programming extensions should be just like programming web pages. So as you'd expect, you'll be programming in JavaScript, which runs inside web pages. Many things your extension will want to do, you can accomplish with existing web APIs. Want it to talk to a server? Use XML HTTP request. Want it to persist some data? Use cookies, local storage, or HTML5 databases. Want it to display a nicely designed options page? Use HTML and cascading style sheets. However, Google Chrome also exposes APIs that only extension code can access. We've tried to make these APIs feel as much like web platform APIs as possible. Let's start with an example. This is code from a simple extension which displays a browser action icon, and when the user clicks on it, it opens up a web page which is packaged within the extension. Already we see a few key aspects of the extension APIs. First, you can identify all the extension calls because they exist in the Chrome namespace. Chrome is a global object to which all extension APIs are bound. The Google Chrome extension APIs are only visible to extension code and are broken down into modules. Here we're using the browser action, tabs, and extension modules. Chrome.browserAction.onClicked is an event which can register listeners who act on something interesting that happens. In this case, the user clicking the browser action icon. Most modules expose events, and they all have the same form, which allows for the addition and removal of listeners. Now let's look at the call to chrome.extension.geturl. This is an example of a synchronous function call, meaning that it does its thing immediately and returns a value to the calling code. In this case, it's constructing a URL, which the browser can use to navigate to a resource, which is within your extension. Some API calls are synchronous, but many are asynchronous. Let's take a look at another example. Here we're asking Google Chrome to modify one of the user's bookmarks by modifying its title. This call is asynchronous, meaning that the code that makes the call will continue executing, and the function you provide as a callback will be run sometime later, at which point your code will know that the bookmark has been updated. The reason why this call is asynchronous has to do with Google Chrome's multi-process architecture. Web pages and JavaScript run in processes, which are not only separate from each other, but also from the main browser process, which alone has the ability to do things like read and write to the local file system. This is an important security and stability feature for Google Chrome. If calls like this were synchronous, your extension would have to stop everything and wait for the browser process to respond to the request. All the while, the user may be trying to interact with the UI of your extension, which has become unresponsive. Using asynchronous APIs is more challenging, but it's in the service of the best user experience possible, and it won't take long to get the hang of it. Just remember that it won't be uncommon to write code like this, rather than this. There's one more interesting thing about this example. There's a bug in it that the extension system is going to help us find. If you look at the documentation for this call, you can see that the ID that chrome.bookmarks.update takes as its first argument is a string, not an integer. When this call executes, the extension system will throw an exception, pointing out the error. The extension's API uses an implementation of JSON schema, which declares the name, type, number, and position of its function arguments. If you call it with the wrong types or wrong number of arguments, it'll complain. Additionally, the extension documentation is generated from exactly the same JSON schema that Google Chrome uses to create its internal API. So, for instance, if you're developing using the beta channel of Google Chrome, you can be assured that the docs at code.google.com/chrome/extensions/beta are accurate. In creating the initial release of the extensions, we focused on creating a robust, secure, and easy-to-use system that included a small set of APIs that we felt would allow many useful extensions to be made. It initially includes interacting with browser windows, tabs, and bookmarks, but we expect to be adding more soon. Have fun working with the Google Chrome extensions, and please let us know what we can do to make your extensions better by giving us feedback at our discussion group.